So I'm messing with my DPI settings. But at any rate, I just finished the last video and I'm going to just keep rolling right here. The Ascended Masters is a concept that was not introduced to the world by Madame Blavatsky, but in this age, she's the appropriate person to probably give credit to. I'm not big on giving credit to anyone. I think you need to know more about what they taught than what their names are. But every great religion has avatars, and even religions, if you don't like that word, then let's say the next thing, like whatever it's going to be, like a hockey. I like hockey. Wayne Gretzky is a ascended master of hockey. Well, he will be when he dies. He kind of still is in the flesh. So, actually, being dead is not a qualification at all. The ascended masters are the people who are the greatest examples of any given field of human culture and human, activity. And so art is one of those things that is not an activity that has a certain form per se, but it's a feeling inside of a person. It's a way to live your life. It's a way to manifest reality. It's a way to be creative and feed the world something that means something. That is a religious process. On the archaeological, paleoarchaeological timeline, the evidence that denotes that human beings are beginning to have religious effects of their culture are art. It's art. And it's when humans do things that aren't just about hunting anymore, or gathering anymore, or building shelter anymore. It's when they do things that are unnecessary, that seem to have ritualistic, meaningful, metaphorical content. And that has grown extraordinarily into all kinds of other things, but you need to understand that that is religious in its nature, and that is the beginning of how human beings begin to arrange themselves as people on the landscape. You cannot remove religion from art. You cannot remove art from religion. You cannot remove truth from beauty. You cannot remove beauty from truth. You cannot separate these things. Truth and art and beauty and love, they all cause you to have the same feeling, which is faith, which is the opposite of fear. You know the feeling of fear very well. So if you know the opposite of fear, then you can understand what faith is. If you misunderstand faith to be some other thing, like, I don't know, a wacky belief in some completely asinine thing that's just ridiculous, then you're stupid. I'm sorry. I don't mean to put you down, but you're just wrong. So you need to figure it out. And that requires having a revolution of mind, a revolution of soul, a revolution of body. This is how things go in this universe. They revolve. Your planet is revolving around its own axis. It is revolving around the sun. The moon is revolving around it. It's all revolving around in the solar system. That is how atoms react. Their electrons revolve around them. Revolution is very, 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 very key. Things do not travel in straight lines. Space is curved. It's something that revolves. Comes back and back, around and around and around and around and around. Reincarnation is this way. All energy is this way. This is not wacky, wacky, mystical bullshit here, people. This is science, okay? And that's not a mystery anymore. Sorry, right? So the things that you used to call mysticism mystery, they're not mystery. They're not mysticism anymore. This isn't mysterious. That I'm here now. This is not a mystery. This is not mysterious. Who am I? This is not a mystery. This is not a joke. This is not fake. Simple. Simplicity. Complexity is actually simplicity. You just need to look at it the right way, folks. Most things are just the same as everything. And all things and nothing. Little circles going around in circles. That's all it is. Now, within that system, you want to cooperate. You got to put creation where it is in the human mind and reality is natural creation and humanity come from females. The universe as a whole is a female entity. There's a reason for that. And if you want to understand it, you need to understand electromagnetics. You need to understand why you call a socket a female part and you call a plug a male part, because you plug the plug into the socket and that's it. I don't have time to go on. I'm going to go over 6 minutes, so let's just go on real quick. The divinity and the dignity of the marginalized, this isn't about them who have their reward here. This is about those of us who are struggling to get by, just to survive with nothing but faith and hope and a prayer to go on. That's what I'm all about, and that's who I'm here for. I am not here for people who are comfortable and fat. I'm here to help the least of you. And that's it for right now.